Right now, it'd be the budget crunch. We've got a fairly large district that grows annually, about equivalent to a school of year, from 600 to 800 students a year. Unfortunately, our tax base is based on sales tax. We have a low property tax base, so we can't build the schools to keep up with the growth in our district. We've made several attempts at trying to get our taxes raised. The voters will keep voting it down, and so we're struggling with that. And so it's been a struggle for us to align our priorities. And of course, the first thing we want to do is actually get classrooms for the kids. We're using portables now, you know, where we can. We build in schools as we can, but we're about tapped out on our borrowing ability because we've built so many schools. And so it's a point in where we have to think about the kids of a safe place for them to go to school first, and then that filters down to other programs, especially the technology program, where if you don't have enough money to build classrooms, it's really hard for you to put those priorities into enhancing your technology. So we're trying to work ways with saving money every which way we can. We use our technology as far as we can. We're trying to keep up our renovating process, where we replace computers ever so often, and then the computers that normally they would have been replacing, we're actually trying to rebuild those to get extended life out of them. And so it's a struggle, but with the money and the demands on education and the demands for technology for education, it really makes it difficult for us to do what we're doing with the funds that are available. The biggest thing as far as some of the tactics we do, of course, and this really paid off, during the fuel shortage or the fuel cost as they grew up, trying to hold those down. And so we've been doing a lot more online staff development. So teachers do not have to travel which adds to mileage things, or for travel for folks to go away. Our state is really working there. A lot of the state staff development that normally we would have traveled to our state capital to attend those, we're now doing those online and through video conferencing. And we're doing the same thing within our own district. We're using video conferencing as much as we can, so teachers don't have to leave their home school and travel to a central place. And that's paying off a lot. Plus, we get the added benefit is that you have less time out of the classroom for those teachers. If you can do it online, and we build some things we call just a minute training, where we'll put some short-term things on there, and the teachers can actually access those training videos whenever they feel like it, or whenever they can. They can do it from home, they can do it in the classroom if they have a break during their planning period or what. So there's a lot of there we're controlling. Two is the standardization of our computers. We put a lot into trying to get a standard computer. I put out a configuration periodically, and that's what the schools buy. It saves them from having to search out and try to find their own. They know where to do. We've got a price list. We have those delivered. We save money on parts, because we can buy in bulk of the same kind of part instead of having to search and hunt for different places and do those. The older computers, as they get older, a lot of times it's not that they're broke or anything, they're just not strong enough to handle the software that's being developed today. So we try to add the memory, we try to add more and more things to make them more robust, and like I said, get a couple more years out of them until finally they're just totally wore out.